May 19. And May 19 is the birthday of Malcolm X. And Malcolm X represented the radical tradition of this country, you know? And what day more appropriate for the graduation of People's College of Law than on the birthday of Malcolm X? So I've just really, like, just even seeing that connection is just one of those things that I think we're so fortunate to have. That's what our school's about. It's like the radical tradition. You know, there's other law schools that you can become a corporate attorney. There's other law schools that you can learn to represent the bourgeoisie, right? But our law school is not supposed to be about that. And all of us came to People's College of Law with an idea of what it was supposed to be. And we were confronted with something entirely different, you know? And there was a real struggle for the soul of People's College of Law. And I'd like to think that the good soul has overcome, and that People's College is back on the road to becoming what we all envisioned, what we all thought. And, you know, in that light, in 2013, I ran for the school board, and I lost. And I remember my wife told me, she goes, if you lose, you need to go back to college and finish your degree. I'd gone to UCLA when I was a young man, and I had some life circumstances that had prevented me from graduating. And so I did that. I went back, and I finished, and I got my bachelor's of arts. And I remember I wanted to go to graduate school because I'm kind of an academic, you know, that's kind of what that's my thing. But I'm also an organizer and an activist in the community. I was one of the founding members of the Southern California Immigration Coalition. I do a lot of education activism, you know, that's kind of what I am. And a lot of people are, you should go to law school. Well, my compañero, who's class of 78 from this fine institution, he kept imposing upon me. He kept saying that, you know, you need to go to People's College. I don't know if I want to be a lawyer, you know, because that's kind of like bourgeois, and it's like, you know, the U.S. laws are kind of like written by rich white guys for rich white guys and all that stuff. But he took me over to the school to do a tour, and there was a young man in the library studying really, really hard because he wanted to pass that first year exam, because that first year exam is really, really difficult. And that young man is sitting here today, you know, with us, you know. I am. This guy right here. People's College of Law is a really different place, you know, and I was happy. I mean, I've known a lot of graduates over the years because in the, LA is a very small activist community, so you always cross, you know, there's people in this audience that I've done, been on coalitions with and done activism with for years, and I've known that they were graduates, but I always thought, I don't want to go to law school, but in retrospect, you know, some of the most amazing organizers and activists that I've ever met in my life, and a lot of them are sitting out here in the audience as well, have all came from PCL, you know. My spiritual guidance from Magda, you know. My academic guidance from people like Alana, whose mind is just so razor sharp that I used to just be, you know, amazed. And all the students that I was able to come in contact with, it's been an experience, and you heard some taste of the struggles that we went through, you know. I witnessed that horrific incident that the young woman was sharing, and I was just astonished that a school that was supposed to stand for social justice, that we would witness something of that, you know, just of that magnitude. I saw the struggles that the particular individuals here were targeted by the previous administration, myself included, and it was a really, really difficult, I mean, you know, a lot of us work full time, and then we're going to law school at night, and then we're dealing with the drama and the politics of the school. It was a lot of stress. You know, there was many times where I really just wanted to pull the plug and say, I'm done with this. You know, I don't want to do this anymore. And somehow we persevered. You know, the class that graduated last year, you know, a lot of those students were also the reason that the school got saved. Several of them are sitting in the office right, the audience right now. And I really want to say my heart goes out to you, because a lot of them forewent taking the bar in July because they sacrificed to save the school. You know, because we had to start from scratch last spring. We had to get all new faculty. We had to get recruit a whole new class of students. We had to do all that stuff. It was us. It was the students and the faculty that remained, and our illustrious dean, and all of the volunteers that were involved. And it was a lot of work. And any of you that are community organizers or activists know, right, that there's always a core group of the people that are the doers, that they're not the ones that are trying to be in the front and get the recognition and get the credit, that they're ones that are doing things like stuffing envelopes or walking door to door, or they're the ones that are making the phone calls to get people to come. You know, those are the people that we turn out at People's College of Law, the doers. you know, the people that roll up their sleeves and do the hard work. And it's just, you know, to know that this portion of the journey is over, you know, is really, for me at least, it's more of a relief than anything else, because it's been so much, you know. But to know that this is, again, this is just another step in the struggles that we all engage in, you know. The keynote speaker was very eloquent about, you know, what we represent and the struggles that face us, you know. We really, really have some big struggles in front of us right now, you know. And we really need the entire community, you know, to be engaged and to come together and work. And that's what People's College of Law is about. It's about collectivity. You know, it's about students coming together and recruiting faculty. It's about faculty arranging their own meetings so that they can evaluate each other. It's really a very unique experience. I want to wrap up just doing the individual thanks. You know, I had my friend John and David and Amy came out for us today. My lovely wife Manjun is here, and then Gabrielle and Diane, who I've known them for many, many decades, and they've really been my spiritual anchor and also kind of my inspiration and struggle. So we're really glad that all of you could come out here today, and thank you for giving us this opportunity.
Thanks, Gabrielle.